Control with Dr. John.
The holidays can be both joyous and extremely stressful, and for many blended families, getting through the holidays is challenging. Joining me this morning with some tips for making the most out of the holidays in a blended family is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klepo. Thanks so much for being here.
Sure, Gina.
The holidays are stressful enough, but for blended families, it really seems to escalate. Why is this and what can be done?
I guess the good news is there's literally thousands of families in exactly the same situation. I think the biggest problem that most blended families get into is trying to hold on to tradition, the logistics of tradition. I mean, the reality is that when divorce happens, things change. And if you can't go with that, you're going to get into trouble. So there's definitely things you can do, though, to make it a little bit more smooth sailing.
Yeah, one of the first things you say to do is don't manipulate the custody order.
Look, those are the ground rules. A lot of times parents don't like the ground rules and they try to change it, they try to get around it. All that does, it causes friction between the parents. That translates into the kids. You've got to work within the custody order, not around it.
Yeah, and you say planning is the key.
When you're in a divorced family, you have to think about things that non-divorced families don't have to think about. So simple things like, what time does the party start? And how long does it take to get the kids to their dad's house? Or who's coming to the house and what time do they need to leave by? I mean, these kinds of little things that seem simple, almost trivial, can make the difference between a lot of conflict and smooth sailing.
And I think in regular families, things don't always go as planned, so you do need to be flexible.
Absolutely, and you need to be flexible in this manner. There's one Christmas Eve, there's one Christmas Day. And the reality is you may not have your kids on that day. Being able to start new traditions, maybe opening presents a day before, maybe having a special dinner 2 days later. If you fight that, if you refuse to sort of deal with that, then the reality is your kids are going to be stressed and so are you.
Yeah, and I think you can start your own traditions. I mean, you do it with your parents and you do it the next generation, and that could be something where your kids want to spend the time with you.
Because ultimately, if you don't, you're going to have kids who feel frustrated. You're going to have kids who feel like they're getting moved back and forth. And that's the last thing. Let your kids share their feelings and don't penalize them if you see them being a little bit irritable, a little bit stressed. A lot of times parents interpret that as the kids aren't grateful, they're not having a good time. The reality is they're dealing with this shuffle. So letting them express it, let them get them off their chest, and everything's going to be smooth sailing.
All right. Great advice as always, Dr. Josh.
Sure, Gina.
Thank you. Stephen?